So I welcome you to the journey of osteoarthritis. Frankly speaking, I am talking on osteoarthritis after almost 7 to 8 years. 7 years to be in fact. Because I gave my PhD presentation at IIT Delhi on diagnosis of osteoarthritis. Since then, I have not talked on osteoarthritis. I have stopped research or search also, forget about research, on osteoarthritis. Initially, I tried with a few BTEC students and tried to encourage MTEC student initially when I was about to finish my PhD. But due to various reasons, and since university do not permit to start research within the 3 years of your PhD work. Okay, so after 3 years of your PhD, your enthusiasm is almost zero to start the topic again. Yeah, and arthritis is painful also. There are various reasons. I will not talk about the reasons, but it's very nice to nice on the behalf of Hamde sir that he said that no, you have to talk on osteoarthritis only. So I accepted that readily and tried to give a presentation here. Okay, so since this is a topic which is very close to my heart, I may over exceed the time limit. Okay, so it is up to the participant that you have to raise your hands and bring me down. Okay, and try, if you feel that some of the things I am taking which are too familiar to you, you can say skip, sir. Okay. Another approach which I took while preparing this presentation is I have gone horizontally instead of vertically, because I am presuming that most of you don't know the physiology and etiology and other symptoms associated with osteoarthritis. So it is better not to go vertically and present the horizontal view of the research which is going in the field of osteoarthritis, diagnosis of osteoarthritis. If anybody wants to go vertical, we can have a separate session in my cabin. Okay, there I can go even vertically also. So don't expect that too many flashy things like wavelet transform or ridgelet transform or any other things in my presentation. It will be only horizontal presentation, not a vertical presentation. Okay, but it will give you overall idea of what is the research going on in the field of osteoarthritis. So I have divided my presentation into very simple thing. I will introduce you to the osteoarthritis. What is it? Osteoarthritis of knee in particular. Then incidence of osteoarthritis, some anatomy, progression, and status of diagnosis of osteoarthritis. I will first deal with some very old studies. Now in the old studies, I have included my study also, because it is quite old now. Right? In the new studies, I am focusing only on image processing modalities. So X-ray, MRI, ultrasound, CT, NM, and all these things. And finally, some summary, some future scope, and epilogue. Okay. So normally my presentations are very lengthy, but I will try to not to stay on one slide particular for long. So for many, it will be like just a zip through of things, but I will give the PDF of this to all participants, so you can then peep in and at your own pace later. Okay. Yeah, yeah. That at least that much. Okay. This was my motto when I was doing research. This is a very famous poem, a couplet of a very famous poem by Rudyard Kipling. Rudyard Kipling, we know as originator of मोगली, चड्डी पहन के फूल खिला है, राइट? जंगल जंगल पता चला है, चड्डी पहन के फूल खिला है वाला जो मोगली है जंगल बुक, वो रुडयार्ड किपलिंग ने लिखा है. बट ही हैज अ वेरी लार्ज कलेक्शन ऑफ पोएम्स क्रिएटेड बाय हिम, एंड दिस इज प्रोबेबली वन ऑफ द टॉप मोस्ट टॉक्ड अबाउट पोएम ऑफ हिज लाइफ. द नेम इज इफ. These two lines in particular, if you can meet with triumph and disaster and treat those two imposters just the same, are written when any Wimbledon player goes in the center court for playing a match on the last wall he faces. So, for example, we are moving out of the hall. So, on the top of that hall, near the door, these two lines are written. That if you can meet with success and disaster and treat those two imposters just the same. This is the philosophy of doing research, because you cannot always get success. Failures are bound to come, but you must have an ability to withstand successes and failures with the same level. You have to treat them with the same level. So this was my philosophy. These two lines have given me lots and lots of positive moments in throughout my PhD life and after also. So this was my motto while doing my PhD. So just as a teaser, can you recognize this? What is this? Anybody? Many of you are surfers now, internet surfers, I mean, right? Not water surfers, but internet surfers. This is a very famous picture. This reads as Kaizen in Japanese. Anybody knows what is Kaizen? Monster? No. Kaizen? It's a management related word nowadays, but basically Kaizen is Japanese term. Management has adopted it. The meaning of this is change good. That means any change is good. If there is a change, it is for good. So, from top to bottom, if entire management is changed, that is also good for the company. Or, top to bottom, if your philosophy is changed, that is also good for you. So, don't be confined to a square only. But why I have started with this, is this is just like a diagnosis, isn't it? This is just like a diagnosis. Yes or no? When we start research on any diagnosis or any signal or anything, pattern recognition, the signals look like this. We don't know anything from that signal. And from that, you have to come to this conclusion that this is this. Right? For this, we have to use the whatever research we are available right now. Isn't it? So, osteoarthritis is just like that. Osteoarthritis is, in common terms, what we call as gudge dukhi in Marathi. Payala dukhla ki apan doctor kade jato 40 nantar maximum. Correct? 40 nantar kiwa 45 nantar. So, that is called as osteoarthritis. Arthritis is a very general term. It's the most common joint condition, but related to the bone and related to the knee joint, that is called as osteoarthritis. So it is a degenerative order of the joints. Now, degenerative means, there are many people who says that if it is degenerative, maybe it can be regenerative also. or it can be corrected also. But osteoarthritis cannot be cured. Cannot be cured. Today also. Right? So it leads to only disability. It leads to disability and it leads to lot of burden to any country, because many people lose their mobility, and because of them, their family members lose mobility because they have to those people. So there is lot of involvement of a lot of things related to economy of osteoarthritis. And then finally, management of osteoarthritis. That means because it cannot be cured, then obviously the people with osteoarthritis must be managed, right? So the management of osteoarthritis is also important as far as the research of osteoarthritis is concerned. So it is very painful, as Professor Hamde has rightly pointed out. Any joint can be affected from the head to toe. You will know various joints are available. If nobody knows how many bones are available, you can ask Munna Bhai, isn't it? So he knows how many bones are available, right? So the bones which are connected to each other via various joints, so any joint can be affected. The most common are knee and hip. Knee, because it is weight-bearing joint. And this is actually like heart, knee is also wonder of a nature. Is really wonder of a nature, because the joint is constructed in such a way that you have to bear the almost whole of your weight throughout your life, right? Since you have started your first step independent first step to the death of last breath of your life, knees have to bear your weight. Isn't it? So it has been constructed in such a way that if there is a wear and tear, you may not feel initially, but later you will feel that there is a lot of wear and tear internally which is going on, and that is why the diagnosis of osteoarthritis is a very important issue. So knee and hip OA have very greater social cost. But I will concentrate only on knee OA, because there is a high incidence of knee OA in India in particular, because of the cross posturing. We sit on cross-legged posture, right? Mandi galun basto apan. Tanantar, traditionally our toilet is also different than Western WCs, right? So there are a lot of things where we intentionally put lot of weight on our knees. We do not care for our knees for centuries together, isn't it? So we have a lot of things. The squatting is there, cross-legging is there, differences of our lifestyle is there. Mainly it affects elderly people, but in that also ladies are affected most. The female part are having more things than the male part. What are the symptoms or what are the risk factors? Main factors are mechanical stress, aging, and hereditary and other constitutional factors. But till today, there is no, in medical, this is normal to say that there is no conclusion as to why this particular disease starts and when it starts. But very important thing here is that when it starts, you will not be knowing when it has started. That is very bad side of osteoarthritis, because the structure of knee is in such a way that this is just a cross section of a very simple figure, and this is just a pictorial view, artistic representation. So we all know, we can recognize this is the thigh bone, this is the tibia, and this part which has end of the femur and end of the tibia, which is shown in sky blue color here and white here, this is called as articular cartilage. Now what is a cartilage? Many of you know what is cartilage. What is cartilage? This is cartilage, nose. This is cartilage. Okay. So when you pierce a hole in the ear, right here, do you feel pain? Pain? Not much. Not much. Very less. Why? Why? Because there are very few pain receptors inside cartilage. There are very few pain receptors inside the cartilage. Correct? It is constructed of such a mesh that the cartilage itself doesn't have many pain receptors. The cartilage also doesn't have the blood supply. Whether cartilage has cells? Whether cartilage has cells? Obviously it must have cells, because the whole body is constructed of cells only. And if there is no cell, and that too living cell, there is no use of putting that particular thing in our body. If the cell is dead, that particular part of your body is dead. So all the cells must be living cells, very few pain receptors, very few blood vessels, but then all the cells in the cartilage must get oxygen from somewhere. Must get oxygen from somewhere, must get other essential fluids from somewhere. So how these fluids are then supplied to cartilage? These fluids are supplied through a special sac known as synovial membrane. So very special arrangement of knee joint. This is called as a synovial joint. The whole joint is encapsulated via a membrane called as a synovial membrane. And that membrane passes the essential fluids inside the knee joint. And then the cartilage is always floating in a fluid called as synovial fluid. That fluid gets all the essential things from blood vessels and then they supply it to a cartilage. Okay, so that is the basic arrangement of the knee joint. Fine? Now when does this osteoarthritis starts? It's basically these, you can consider these cartilage things as shock absorbers. It's just like a shock absorber things, right? So if you put weight on this side and there is a ground on that side, right? You do not feel anything, right? Do you feel anything that one bone is touching to the other bone? No. Why? Again, two things. That cartilage doesn't have pain receptors. And second thing, it acts as a shock absorber. The whole arrangement is done in such a way that the joint is very free inside and they are shock absorber things. So when does the osteoarthritis start then? And before going to osteoarthritis, let us also know the muscles associated with knee movement. There are basically two muscles. The top side of the muscle is called as quadriceps muscles and the bottom side of the muscles are called as hamstring muscles. And we know that when we want to lift our knee, then the quadriceps muscle should contract, and when we lower our knee, then hamstring muscle should contact, right? So these muscles are for lifting the knee up and these muscles are for bringing your knee down, bringing your leg down, okay? So these things are also very important, take part in osteoarthritis formation, and some of the things also are affected. So etiology is not fully understood of OA progression. But it is a very, very slow process and a multifaceted process. And the pathological changes are also there. I am not going into the deep because this is not a medical class. Correct? But it is very difficult to diagnose the exact occurrence and the progression of disease in the initial stages. And why we are not aware of any changes, those are happening because we do not feel any pain out of it. We go to the physician only if we have a pain. And when will we have a pain? When will we have pain? When the cartilage gets damaged and the nerve endings become open, then our brain gets sensation that there is a pain inside your knee. So the cartilage must be damaged in this fashion. Correct? The part which is acting as a shock absorber and which is also very important for the lifelong protection of our knee joints gets distorted, right? Gets roughened, and then the exposure to the nerve endings will happen, and when then you are walking or when you are just waking up from your bed, you will feel intense pain. There is also called as locking there, correct? Especially it happens in winters, locking of knee with some characteristic sound also. Especially in the old age, you can ask your parents, right? What this locking means and what is this characteristic sounds. So, again, I will not go into the details of all this, but there is one animation of how the osteoarthritis progresses. It's a very small animation. So just play that animation. Whatever I have explained, just see, these are cartilages. Meniscuses are just wedge-like, they are also like cartilages. They improve the stability of the knee. Forget about this, what are these? Okay. So here you can see the damage happening to the cartilage, and then red is indicating the intense pain. Now this is one of the, ways of, we are going very soon to this X-ray diagnosis. And you can see when you move your leg, the bones touch each other, and since they have nerve endings, you will feel intense pain. Okay? Then while walking, you can have pain and then you limp. So wherever there is less pain, you try to shift your weight to that side. Okay? So there are other things also, but let us skip those things. So how to do diagnosis? Now we'll come to diagnosis of osteoarthritis. Look at this picture. What these people are doing? They are measuring blood pressure of a horse. And how they are measuring? Just see here. They have cut the actual artery and put the pipe so that they are measuring how blood rises above and then marking. Do you think this is a just fun experiment or a fake experiment? No, this is how people initially started. This is how people initially started with. For measurement of blood pressure. Correct? So all these diagnoses we have to do with knee. So you have to cut your knee, right? Yes or no? You have to cut your knee. So those diagnoses are called as invasive diagnosis. Now you don't have to cut the entire knee, fortunately, because there are pinhole cameras which you can insert inside, isn't it? But then also you need a small operation there. Yes or no? Just like your angiography, correct? You have to insert something. So both arthroscopy and arthrography are invasive and they require minor surgery. So nowadays, if anything, your body has to be pierced, those kind of techniques are avoided, isn't it? Can we do non-invasive diagnosis? This is the foremost question in any part of diagnosis. So I will start with very old studies initially. So these studies are dating back to 1976, where there were lot of computers, PCs, and lot of DSP techniques also. So initially Chu and other people, they started with acoustical pattern recognition techniques. I told you that osteoarthritis has a characteristic sound associated with it, right? So what they tried to do? They tried to measure the sound related to osteoarthritis, and then they did some acoustical studies, frequency studies, autocorrelation studies, and amplitude analysis studies, very preliminary analysis at that time. And they found out that there is some difference between the autocorrelation function and all other things. Very preliminary studies they have done. So picking up from this, there is another group called as R.M. Rangayan of University of Calgary. The people who are associated with mammography probably know this man. He is Indian origin man, R.M. Rangayan, who has lot of papers in vibroarthrography. The idea is also same, but instead of using sound sensors, these people have used accelerometers. Accelerometers means vibrations they have measured in terms of accelerometer. Again, same, it is not clinically yet accepted. So those studies also, there are very large number of papers, and when I started studying about osteoarthritis, these people were having lot of papers on osteoarthritis. So I started with the intention of mimicking them first, that can we go and can we extend their work at IIT Delhi. But later I did not. So this is normal vibroarthrography waveform, and this is a pathological arthrovibrography waveform. And by looking at it also, any pattern recognition person can say that definitely they will have different feature vectors, and you can have diagnosis of osteoarthritis very easily. But then they did not continue these studies also for some reason, and then I started my work around the same time. I started my work with two motivational sentences. The journey is the reward, and the reward of thing well done is to have done it. Because I was alone working in the lab on osteoarthritis, and I had talked to many of my colleagues regarding the situation which I was in. I had one guide who was coming from he was basically animal doctor, okay. And the other guide, she did not know even how to do filtering, simple filtering. So with the combination of these two guides, I started my work on osteoarthritis. Okay. So there were a lot of problems initially. So I thought that, okay, now I have chosen a topic, so I must do something. Otherwise, government will take 7 lakh rupees from me, which I wrote in my bond that I will repay my 6 years salary if I do not finish my PhD. Isn't it? There is a government bond for QIP students. So I thought, okay, let us go. Let us start the journey. So I chose two different signals. I chose one signal which is called as plethysmography signal, electrical impedance plethysmography signals. Now this I chose because one of my guide had his original work on plethysmography. And he actually told me that Suhas, do in this area, you will get PhD, when I was a very new student of his, right? Okay, so I said okay. Then my other guide said, Suhas, only this will not fetch you PhD, so you should pick up another signal. So I picked up electromyography. And I picked up that signal because she promised me that she will give me electrography machine, right, electrograph machine within 6 months. Within 6 months of my entry to IIT Delhi. Okay, then I picked up subjects, I outlined all my research activities and I picked up age group of 45 to 64. I worked in collaboration with Department of PMR, Physical Medicine and Rehabilitation, at All India Institute of Medical Sciences, New Delhi. Okay. So, IIT Delhi and AIIMS, New Delhi, these are premier institutions in their own right. And the joint department is Biomedical Department of IIT Delhi. So, I felt very happy. So, I chose control groups, I chose osteoarthritis group, lot of exclusion criteria, inclusion criteria. I designed forms for subject data collection, age, body mass index, their habits, what they do, etc., etc. A lot of forms I developed. And I studied for two protocols. One I called as knee swing protocol and the other I called as normal walking protocol. For knee swing, I didn't have to think about much because you just have one table and the subject sits on the table and then raises the knee up and raises the knee down. I don't have to worry about instrumentation. For walking study, then I needed at least a big hall with wireless data acquisition system so that I can pick up the signals with proper and normal walking. So I waited and waited for these data acquisition systems, but I did not get. But the time was fast approaching, then I decided that okay, I have only a hall of 10 by 5 or 10 by 6. So in that hall, I started my studies on walking also. So what I did, with all electrodes attached, I asked the subject to go up to that point, come back, go up to this point, come back, go to that point. And I made him walk for 1 minute. And then I pruned the signals picked up only for walking studies. So I will show you some part of the signals. So methodology for the pain reporting, how much pain you feel, how much disability you feel, there are two indexes called as Lacune index and WOMAC index. So there are various points and I prepared questionnaire of Lacune and WOMAC also. So the typical knee swing experiment gets signals like this. These green ones are actually, I prepared a simple monostable multivibrator, a single monoshot, so that I can have some marking on it, that where is the signal which is going when it is up, knee is up, leg is up and leg is down. Okay, so these green things are markers, simple markers, right? And these are walking signals. So you can see that here, these are only 3 steps the person can walk in 10 feet hall, right? Not more than that. Walking normally only for 3 steps. So I picked up only three signals here which are walking signals. And I can pick up many signals from this. So finally after pruning the signals, separating them, I could have these knee swing signals for normal subjects. Sorry, these two for normal subjects, controls, and these for OA subjects. And you can see that there is difference at least in the amplitude. Okay. So I started with the amplitude studies. So I just took amplitude things for my classification studies. And the number of correct classifications were in the range more than 66%. Okay, I will skip the details part here. Then I started with EMG signals. For EMG signals also the same thing. I needed to pick some muscles which are associated with knee. So I picked up three muscles. This is rectus femoris, vastus medialis and vastus lateralis. So I gave the short forms as RF, VL and VM. Okay, so these three muscles. And the fourth one, as you must have noticed, it is a marker, right? So when the knee is up and when the knee is down. So it's a very simple marker. So these are close-up things of all those things. So you need to have signal conditioning. So I did signal conditioning which are suitable. And then finally I cropped all the knee swing signals. And finally, since I had many knee swing signals, initially I started the studies on only amplitudes, because the amplitude things mattered a lot. So you can see that for typical control subjects and typical OA subjects, the amplitudes are having drastic difference. These are not looking different, but just see their y-axis, right? So here you can see the scale of 0 to 100 and here scale of 0 to 25. So actually amplitude wise they have lot of difference. And then I did some skew corrections, because the time which you take to move your leg up may not be same as time you require for to move leg down. So I adjusted their peaks so that all the signals look like same. Then I took the temporal average as well as all the other averages. And then finally for control subjects, I had very smooth signals. And for OA subjects also, I had very smooth signals. Then I started my studies, but after initial studies, I started whether I can have the progression of knee OA, because I could find that I had an idea to start the early diagnosis of osteoarthritis, right? So to have early diagnosis, I must have a progression recorded, correct? So I divided all my subjects into four parts. I called first one as NN1, NN, second one as NN2, third one as OA2 and fourth one as OA1. So NN1 is a normal healthy volunteers, and OA1 was definitely having osteoarthritis for more than 2 years with all other evidences also. And in between I picked up two groups. So with these four groups I started my studies. These are the Lacune scores and WMAC scores showing the progression of their pain and discomfort. Correct? So it's quite progressive, isn't it? Then what about the EMGs? Then I took only amplitude studies here initially. And then for results of all those signals, RF is rectus femoris, VL is vastus lateralis, and VM is vastus medialis. You can see the error bar shows standard deviation, but you can see that this is definitely progressing down. So the amplitude, the peak amplitude, the average amplitudes, all these are progressively going down. So can I pick up these amplitudes of these three muscles as a feature vector? Then I must do some hypothesis testing studies, right? So I did hypothesis testing also, and then I found out the significance test gave me an indication that definitely between NN1 to NN2, I am not getting a very good result of this P, but NN1 to OA2, NN1 to OA1, and NN2 to OA2, NN2 to OA1, some things I am getting. At least I can have differentiation between say first group and third group, second group and fourth group, that kind of differentiation I might have. So I started with classification, and I'm again not going into the details, but NN1 to NN2 also I could get correct 100% classifications with only three features, and NN2 to OA2 I could have again 100% classifications. But the major problem was between OA2 to OA1, where I got only maximum 82% efficiency, because already those subjects were having, I told you that a subject will go to a physician only when he or she is having pain. So they might have started with osteoarthritis before, right? So much before they must have gone to the physician. So there was a difficulty in getting this osteoarthritis 1 to osteoarthritis 2, this group. Severe to moderate osteoarthritis, there was a problem. That problem is quite evident. Okay. So the conclusions were that sometimes a noble failure serves the world as faithfully as a distinguished success. Because I tried the experiments on plethysmography also for the groups, but I failed. Because those data cannot reveal the progression. So that was one of the failure. But this is also a very great success, isn't it? So I can say that other people don't go on plethysmography side. So that is also a success. That way is blocked. No entry there. And our greatest glory is not in never failing, but in rising every time we fall. So probably we should start something new. Why you have to do research now also? Because diagnosis is of osteoarthritis, that too in early condition, is still a challenge. Still a challenge. So what there are various significance of the studies which I will skip. But just two lines I will tell you, that whenever you do any biomedical instrumentation side, any diagnosis side, keep in mind that although we have influenced a lot, but the cost also is going up very high. So biomedical engineering is a problem also, it's not a solution only. So we must also think of the cost involved in the biomedical instrumentation. Otherwise, the society will feel a lot of trouble. So I searched Google recently as today also, and picked up some papers here. So I will not go into the details of this. I am giving this to all of you, including papers. Just I want to tell you that those people who complain that I do not have IEEE subscription, I do not have Elsevier subscription in our college, these things I have done on my mobile internet. All the papers which I have downloaded from my mobile internet. Correct? So where I do not have any IEEE subscription, I do not have any Elsevier subscription. So there are a lot of papers available in open access also. And these papers I have collected as recent as from 2011 to 2016 also. Because they are EPUB publications ahead of print. Sometimes they print, they are printed even ahead of the year, right? So there are many papers which are available. So I have picked up just up to 2014 here only. So I will give all these papers to you. But one of the very important thing to discuss here, those people who probably may be interested in doing research in osteoarthritis, that this is one group called as OAI, Osteoarthritis Initiative. This group has taken lead when I was about to finish my PhD, and they have started keeping databases free of cost for people to do research in this field. So this research, this osteoarthritis initiative, you can go to the website of this OAI and can find that there are many things. For example, various images they have kept, and as recently as February 2013, 72-month X-ray and MRI images for the entire cohort. So 72-month means that is a follow-up study. In medical terminology, the follow-up studies are very important, because then only you can know the progression. So to study the progression, you must have a data of follow-up study. It is very difficult to have a follow-up study in places like Nanded, is a tertiary centers or centers like Nanded, because we do not have even the manpower, we do not have even the money involved and the people involved, and our people, I mean our society doesn't have this kind of broad outlook, that if somebody comes to a physician and if you are telling him or her that you are normal, and then again after 6 months if you call him or her that aapka ek aur x-ray lena hai for our study, they say aapne to 6 mahine pehle bataya tha normal hai, ab main kyun aau? This kind of response you may get. But the Western society, they are aware of all these studies. So at least their data we can take and we can do the follow-up research. Because for early diagnosis, this kind of data of follow-up is very, very essential. It also has medical image assessments data also. So various MRI data and all those data, and here you can see new data available as new as February 2015. So very recent data also they put there. Obviously they must have a lot of papers already on that data, and then they put the data for public knowledge. Otherwise then if Indian people take the data and publish paper ahead of them, then their whole exercise will be of no use for them, right? So this free data has some good things as well as bad things. This is one of the bad thing as far as the research with free data is concerned. What bad thing? That you must be thinking more than what the group has already published on the same data. Then only you will get your papers published in similar kind of journals. Right? So this is very important for the research of this. A lot of data is available, and what you have to do is just create a free, correct? Nothing else. You don't require any, create your account, just log on there, have some declarations that you will not earn money out of this, etc., etc. A lot of things are there, and there are very good tutorials also. They have kept very good tutorials on the data as well as how to use the data. Lot of tutorials are there. You can download the data, have presentations. There are some forms also which you must comply with. For example, this is analysis proposal form. They will review your proposal and then they will give you the consent of using the data. Same forms are available for presentations also, because their name is associated with your work. They are very critical on evaluating your technical writings also. Okay, so there are some manuscript approval forms also. So you must follow their procedure. So up to this, this was just the beginning of osteoarthritis research. The actual research starts here, and here I will go almost very fast, because I will not speak a single word or single equation here. I will not write a single equation here. I have not written anything so far, but I will not again. So what are the things which are going in radiography? What is radiography? The X-ray image, right? Basically X-ray image. When you just say radiography, we know X-ray image. So can we do osteoarthritis diagnosis using radiography? Obviously, because when the cartilage gets damaged, right, then probably the X-ray which you are taking must give something. So what we have to see here, first thing is that whenever you go to a physician with a pain in your knees, he will advise you to have X-ray. And since when these X-rays are taken? When the X-rays were invented, right? X-rays were invented somewhere around the first decade of 20th century, right? Before, even just just before 1893, I think, to be in fact. Röntgen invented it. But they were used for diagnosis of osteoarthritis when two people known as Kellgren and Lorenz had a semi-quantitative assessment scale. It is called as a KL scale. Okay, so most often that is based on the evidence of cartilage loss. That means here you can see there is a lot of gap, right? So what that gap indicates? That there is a lot of cartilage is available because cushioning is available from that side. But here you do not see a gap here. What does it mean? It means that cartilage is damaged and the two bones are touching to each other when you are standing on weight bearing position there. So you can conclude here that definitely on this part you must be having osteoarthritis, right? But here also you can see the disadvantage here is that this joint space width measurement you can take only when lot of cartilage is damaged. When do you have joint space narrowing? When do you have joint space narrowing in X-ray? When cartilage is damaged, isn't it? You will have joint space narrowing when cartilage is damaged. That means you have already gone well ahead in your disease. And there is no coming back. Right? There is no coming back. So this is only used when your disease is well progressed. Okay? So Kellgren has introduced the scale in 1957. And we still use that scale. Many doctors still we use that scale, KL0 to KL4. That scale to have the diagnosis of osteoarthritis. But Altman also has proposed a new scale somewhere around 1995. This is more exhaustive scales, more exhaustive classification of osteoarthritis. He has also included various sides also. Kellgren scale, didn't include whether it is on this side of the knee or this side of the knee or this side of the knee or back side of the knee. Kellgren doesn't have any of these classifications. But Altman has proposed these things, but very few people use this in actual clinical environment. This Altman scale also is used mostly in research environments. Okay, and there are a lot of disadvantages of X-ray. We all know that they are harmful radiations. And for the follow-up studies, you have to expose the patient, the subject, with X-rays again and again, which may further enhance the disease also, and it is carcinogenic also. So there is a chance of getting cancer developed because of X-rays, right? So these are very harmful rays. So a lot of people have done a lot of studies with joint space narrowing. Can we have automated joint space narrowing based on X-rays? Can we correlate them with MRIs? So a lot of studies are there. I have given many references here itself on the same slide. So those who are interested, those can go there. Some have software to automatically measure the joint space narrowing and minimum joint space width also. So MJSW coefficient they have found out. Based on that, then you can classify whether you are having osteoarthritis. If yes, then of which grade and so on. A few people also have tried digital tomosynthesis. This tomo is as same as computer tomography. That means it's actually back substitution calculations of various slices of pictures you take and then create a virtual 3D environment of how the knee is looking like. Okay, so there are some studies of this also. They have compared it with the X-ray. This is very important thing to note down for osteoarthritis people, that whatever you do today with latest research also, you have to compare it with X-ray results. There is no escape here. you must compare your results with X-ray results. Then only your paper will get published and your research will get accepted. Some people have tried fractal analysis also, because in X-ray the texture is varied, right? Because the various parts of your knee, when they are exposed to X-rays, some parts will have more absorption, some parts will have less absorption. So they will produce a fractal kind of texture. So many people have used fractal analysis also. Quickly I will turn to MRI, because this is latest and hot topic, and lot of MRI images are available on Osteoarthritis Initiative also. And you can see that in MRI also, MRI is just again similar to X-ray, but in this is much better, because it can visualize even soft tissues properly, and you can have even 3D structure of your knee joint also, if you wish to have. So a lot of studies are developed. These two pictures I have picked up from the historical perspective, that this is the same person who invented MRI, and he has put his leg in MRI scanner there. So you have to show to the world that this device is not harmful. So whatever you do, you must get a stamp first that this is not harmful at all, then only doctors will use it. And just as on the sidelines of this, I will tell you a very bad incidence in India, that one of the top researchers in India in plethysmography, in BARC, I will not tell his name here, but he worked for almost 30 to 40 years of his life in promoting one machine he developed in impedance plethysmography to measure the blood volume of a heart, how much blood volume your heart carries. So he went from a simple physician to the topmost physicians in India, but still his equipment is not used in the actual environment. After 40 years of studies and various research papers and various stamps also, that this research can be used in clinical environment, still his instrument is not used. Okay, so you have to be such patient people, not patient as that kind of other patients we are talking about. Patience I am talking about, right? Patient means the people having lot of patience. And these are the people who invented whole body MRI. So MRI, everybody knows, you can have a lot of advantages with MRI. And the major drawback of MRI is cost. Cost is right now a major drawback, and a lot of contraindications are there. People who are having claustrophobia, that means fear of closed spaces, for them it's not advised to use MRI. People with pacemaker also cannot be inserted in MRI machine, because it's magnetic, right? So it may affect the pacemaking. But various instruments are available, various MRI machines are available for research, and various methodologies are also available. So the relevance of sequences is obviously there. You can have a lot of studies of joint space narrowing, such as quantitative analysis of how much cartilage was there initially, how much it is lost, and you can have progression of all this also. So many things you can have using your latest image processing techniques. Okay, and you can almost have all the parts of your knee joint considered. So because of that, you have a lot of analysis also. So these are semi-quantitative scoring systems proposed by some of the researchers. I have picked up only from 2004 to 2011. So you can also propose a score yourself if you do research. So if your score is good, easily acceptable to the world community, you can have a stamp of your research on the score. So there are various methods of how to calculate the joint space narrowings and the structures associated with cartilage. You can also have the 3D picture or pattern classification things, that this part is having more erosion, this part is having less erosion. You can give color indications. And then you can have even 3D structures out of this. So I'm just going very fast now because Kokri sir is already here. So you can have 3D structures of all those, because you have slices of MRIs, right? So you can have 3D structures and have study. So this case study I have picked up, but I will not go into the details. They have done segmentations based on Atlas based on the registration techniques also. And the results were quite good. Okay? And you know the features they have used are very simple features which normally are used. And since this was picked up from Osteoarthritis Initiative database, they could have a progression study also. The progression study is also very important here. You can choose even ultrasound, but the disadvantage of ultrasound is that you do not get a very good visualization of soft tissues here. So very few studies are available on ultrasound, which I will totally skip. Then CT images are constructed using X-ray images only, but those are slices of X-rays, and you can again have a 3D structure built out of it. So the other methods are optical coherence tomography, then you can have even nuclear imaging, PET and other things. You can have combination also, fusion of PET and MRI, PET and CT, such fusion also you can have. So a lot of things are there to study. But out of this sentence is very important, that clinical role of MRI and all other studies are still in limitation. This is still minor, because these techniques are still not used for routine osteoarthritis diagnosis. So it is up to us, the image processing people and biomedical engineering people in general, to make the cost of these things down, especially related with diagnosis things, right? Because X-ray machines or the MRI machines, the cost is decided by the manufacturer of those machines. But at least if we can do something for faster diagnosis, for accurate diagnosis, for early diagnosis, then people will even give money if the management of osteoarthritis they want. Okay. So the current news, there are some current papers I picked up, and the credit of these papers at least, which I am showing, goes to Akash, who is our student now, who will be, where is Akash? He has not come. Okay. So the credit of these papers goes to him. Finally, I think many people must have seen these few slides, but I am repeating this for people who are new to this class. This is a story that great work is its own reward. You don't have to worry about the result of what you are doing. You must do. The journey is its own reward. Like that, the great work is its own reward. When someone tells you that you can't do something, look around. Consider all options, then go for it. Use all the traits within you. Be creative. In the end, you will succeed. Okay? So thinking must become your capital asset, no matter whatever ups and downs you come across your life. And I am an admirer of this person, and I also like one of his another sentences: technology, unlike science, is a group activity. It is not based on individual intelligence, but on the interaction of many people. So I thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity to present some of the things what I have done and some of the things related to osteoarthritis. Thank you very much.